windshield. Amanda Nunes, you know Clarissa, she was your teammate in the Olympics. Right. Amanda Nunes at a boxing ring, she knocks her out, what, one round, two rounds?
I don't know, listen, man. Listen, I think, isn't Amanda too small, though?
No, they're going to fight for $1 million.
I seen that, but I'm saying.
Jose, your roommate's here from the Olympics.
That's my bro. Like I said, man.
He's a good dude.
Jose's been always a great guy. Champion. Yeah, exactly. Thank you. I appreciate that, Jose.
You're both the champions now. Who's the champion from that Olympic team?
Errol Spence.
Errol Spence. No, Wilder was 4 years before.
No, Wilder was 08.
Okay. So but, Spence, Clarissa.
Rashid Warren had was the title also. Damn, who else?
It's crazy how they went to the Olympics 132 and
right, we should sign, right? Yeah. 135
champion, 145
champion.
That's crazy. Yeah, we switched roles, but yeah, man, like I think like I said, Clarissa. Marlene was close, you know, she lost to Sunisa Estrada. I know, like I said, my boy Marcus Brown, he's coming back. I spoke to him over the weekend. He should be back in January. Shout out to my man Marcus Brown. But Brazil fought for the title twice. My boy Terrell Boucher fought. He fought a lot for the title. But like for the most part, for my team, even though we didn't medal in terms of the men's side, shout out to both Clarissa and Marlon for at least getting us some medals on that team. But like in terms of the men who didn't medal, we already fought. We either fought or won for world titles already. In terms of our whole team.
By the way, Jermell, do you follow Pita on Twitter?
Yeah, I follow him, man.
So you see all his tweets.
Pita crazy.
What? No, he's not crazy. He keeps it 100. He's like Nate Diaz of Twitter. You're Nate Diaz of Twitter.
He speaks his mind. I give him that. He speaks his mind. So, but we all, but like, hey, long as I'm just happy. Like, I'm just happy. I haven't been, on a criticism.
Hey, is he ever gonna be on your hit list? Well, if you do a story like they did with Teofimo and get on his bad side, he will comment. What did you say? What did you say?
It was like the Michael Conley fight went the distance, right? Yeah. So it went the distance, and then they still took like fucking 30, 45 minutes to start the Teofimo fight.
I said the same thing because I was in the back.
It was like a first round knockout that you understand. They got.
Yeah, I was in the back, and I was like, why is this?
You said, who cares about this crap? I want to see the fight.
You want to watch Teofimo fight, not care.
People wanted to see the fight. I get that point to a certain degree. Like, I was in the back. I was like, yo, why does it take so long? Because I wanted to see the fight. Because it was a big fight, anticipated fight. But it is what it is, man. I'm just glad that I ain't been on his own. His crosshairs.
Hey, Pita, what did you say last week, the week before that got people? Oh, you said you never want to see Joshua fight again until Wilder puts him to sleep.
No, I seen what he said about Andre.
What'd he say? Oh, wow.
I was like,
yeah. He said, stay retired.
That that's cold, man.
But you know what? He keeps it 100.
He speaks his mind. He can't be mad about that. Hey, he speaks his mind. Can't be mad about that. But
you have to respect people who are honest. And I don't like when I ask a fighter who don't fight next, talk to my promoter. What does that mean? You're the fighter. Who do you want?
That's why, man. Like, you know me. Ellie, I've been everywhere, bro. I've been on all sides of the streets.
I saw you at Broner's gym. I saw you here and there.
And for the most part, you're my witness. I'm still cool with all them guys.
You are?
I have no issue with the
PBC. Even though some reporters try to start shit. And you're
of course.
I clear them
all the time, man. But like I said, I think it all comes down to the fighter. Like, the fighter has to really push it. You know what I mean? Your promoter, their job is to basically, to promote and build a fight. But, like, if you really want to fight, man, you can really push for a fight.
That's true.
Like, even with my mandatory, but it was no issue making a Lamont Rose fight with Golden Boy.
That's true. That was a great fight. He's a great dude.
When Jose fought my man Mo. That's Eddie, you know what I'm saying?
Hey,
that wasn't a mandatory.
You know what?
That fight easily.
That's one of the best fights this year. Yeah. But it wasn't on the list of fights of the year. Do you see that, Pita? They made a list of fights of the year nominations.
Oh, the BWA.
The Boxing Writers, they skipped on Jose's fight. They don't watch boxing or what? That should have been one of the fights.
But like I'm saying, back to what I was saying, bro, like, fights can be made. If fighters, it's the fighters. Like I said, Jose and Mo, they won the fight.
Okay.
Eddie Hearn and Bob made the fight.
You heard Tim Bradley, right? What was that?
I caught it. I mean, a lot of people disagree with Tim. Like I said, I respect, like, Tim's another one, just like him, speaks his mind. I mean, like I said, Tim basically is coming like the fans.
He wears his emotions on his
face.
No, he said that he wanted the PBC fighters to put their big boy pants on.
He said basically nobody at PBC.
Pita, listen to this.
The only man he respects on PBC is Wilder, because Wilder wants to fight outside of the stable.
He said that the 147 pounders PBC need to put on their big boy pants and come over and fight Crawford.
I think Crawford beats all of them.
You think Crawford beats all of them?
Yeah.
I don't know if he beats all of them.
What do you think?
Errol? What about Danny?
He'll knock Danny out.
What about, you say knock Danny out? What about Ugas?
Oh, Ugas probably gave him a good fight.
Ugas? I think
he said Ugas. I think Ugas beat him in amateurs.
Oh, they did?
I think
for them. No, Ugas is a very awkward fighter.
I still think Bud beats him.
I would hate to fight Ugas. It's just hard.
Ugas is a cool dude. Ugas gives anybody problems. You see, when Ugas first Sean, people automatically assume that Sean was going to have a rough time with Errol because of his performance with Ugas. But it's all about, like I said, styles make fights, yo. And like I said, for the most part, Errol's my boy. I speak to him all the time, too. I'm just glad that he's recovering. You know, I want to see him back in the big fights. You know what I'm saying? I love him to death. I love his family. His family's from Long Island. And don't let Errol fool you. Errol was born in New York. Don't let him fool you with that Dallas, Texas man. So, I was listening to him about that all the time. But I just want to see him, back at 100%, because, like I say, he's not only a good fighter, he's a good friend.